We have completed chapter number 13, that is Delhi. And now we did chapter number 13, Delhi complete kiya tha. Then we did the worksheet reading. Today we will read the chapter. Okay, hum textbook mein jo chapter diya hai, wo hum read karenge. Okay, so let us begin. So, this is your chapter. Let us begin reading it. Delhi is a historical place. This beautiful city is situated along the banks of the river Yamuna. So, look at the map over here. See, this is the map of Delhi. And see, there are so many places in it. And it is located along the banks of the river Yamuna. So this is where the river Yamuna flows. See, Yamuna river yahan pe flow hoti hai. And ye pura map Delhi ka hai. Isme jo bhi areas hai, that is Kishanganj, and I'll show you. See, Najafgarh, all this is nearby Delhi. Okay, now it has been the capital of many kings and emperors in the past. The city of Delhi was first built by the Pandav kings. It was known as Indraprastha. So it is important, underline it. Much later, an emperor named Shah Jahan rebuilt the city and called it Shah Jahanabad. So whichever I am, see, jo bhi main underline kar rahi, you also have to underline. The British built New Delhi as the capital of India. So it is important for fill in the blank. The city was planned and designed by a British architect, Sir Edwin Newton. New Delhi is our national capital. The official name of Delhi is the National Capital Territory of Delhi. Very important. Please underline it. It is surrounded by Uttar Pradesh on the eastern side and Haryana on the other three sides. The Rashtrapati Bhavan is in New Delhi. The President of India lives here. All main government offices are in New Delhi. The Central Secretariat Building has two blocks. The Central Secretariat Building has two blocks. The ministers have their offices here. The Prime Minister's office is in South Block. So, South Block mein Prime Minister ka office hai. Then other ministers and departments of the Indian government work from offices around the South Block. The parliament has two houses. So how many houses does the parliament has? Two, that is Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. Members hold their discussions and meetings here. The governments of other countries also have offices in Delhi. Dusri foreign countries ki offices bhi Delhi mein hai. These foreign offices are called embassies or high commissions. Very important. The climate of Delhi is extreme. It has very hot summers, hot and dry winds called Loo blow from April to June. The winters are very cold and it rains from July to September. Tourists from all over the world visit Delhi. They come here to see its heritage. They visit historical monuments like the Red Fort, Qutub Minar, Jantar Mantar, and the Jama Masjid. Now, when we talk about historical monuments, ki jab hum baat kare, so these will be included. Okay? Now, on 15th August, the Prime Minister of India hoists the national flag at the Red Fort. The Jama Masjid, one of the largest and most beautiful mosques in India, was built by Shah Jahan. The observatory at Jantar Mantar was built by Maharaja Jai Singh II. Okay, and in the same way, in the line, Jama Masjid was built by Shah Jahan. Okay, it was used to study the sun, the moon, the stars, and the planets. The Qutub Minar was built by Qutbuddin Aibak. Shankar's International Dogs Museum, Humayun's Tomb, Nehru Planetarium, Rajghat, Shantivan, India Gate, Zoo, and the Lodi Garden are some of the other places of tourist interest. The Mughal Garden, situated within the Rashtrapati Bhavan, is the most beautiful garden of Delhi. So, sabse beautiful garden, Mughal Garden of Delhi. The Rajghat is the Samadhi of Mahatma Gandhi ji. Important. Okay? Mahatma Gandhi ji ki Samadhi is Rajghat. The Shantivan is the memorial of India's first Prime Minister, Jawaharlal Nehru ji. The Amar Jawan Jyoti is a flame lit at the India Gate. This flame burns continuously in the memory of the Jawans who sacrificed their lives for India. Delhi has some well-known religious places that attract Indians as well as the other tourists from all over the world. The Birla Mandir, Gurdwara Bangla Sahib, Jama Masjid, St. James Church, Lotus Temple and the Akshardham Temple further add to the beauty of the capital. Delhi has many stadiums like the Jawaharlal Nehru Stadium, the Indira Gandhi Stadium and the Tapakora Stadium. Important sporting events are held here. Okay? The city of Delhi successfully hosted the Commonwealth Games in 2010. Very important. Well-developed modern roads, bridges and flyovers have made Delhi a modern and comfortable city to live in. It is a well-connected city and the Delhi Metro provides a fast and cheap means of transport to the people. In Delhi, all festivals like Holi, Diwali, Eid, Dashera, Navroz, Easter, Christmas, Gurupurab, Pongal and Sankranti are celebrated with joy. Men normally wear trousers and shirts and women wear saris, salwar kameez or western dresses. In Delhi you meet people of different states as it is famous for job opportunities and education. As a result, we come across many cultures of different states of India and also of other countries. They may speak different languages and celebrate their festivals, but they love this lively city. Therefore, Delhi can be called a mini India. So, this is important. I've already told you that Delhi is called a mini India. So this kind of question can come. Ki give reason why is Delhi called a mini India. So usme aapko That is the festivals that are celebrated. Okay, then men wear trousers and shirts. Women wear salwar kameez, western dresses, etc. Then there are many opportunities for job and education. As a result, there are people from different states in India. Different languages and festivals are celebrated. And so Delhi is known as Mini India. Okay students, so agar aapko ye answer aaye to aapko aise likhna hai. This is the reasons, that is following are the reasons why Delhi is known as Mini India. Okay, so I hope the chapter is clear to all of you. We will meet in the next class. This is it for now. Happy Diwali to all of you. Complete your notebooks. Start studying.